I'm in Pensacola, Florida at the National Naval Air Museum. You have to have an ID to get on base, though they do have open weekends that allow the general public in.
Thank you. particular day on the 4th of December, we were launched about 1 or 1:30 in the afternoon, armed reconnaissance flight. We had a flight of 6 aircraft. There were 4 in our division. There was a section of 2 other aircraft flying maybe a half a mile away from us. During this time, we're flying up in the mountains. Mountains were anywhere between 6 and 7,000 feet above sea level. And almost all of the ground we were flying over was covered with trees, evergreens. When my section leader, Jesse Brown, called that he had been hit, he was losing power, when he was going to have to crash land. And somebody saw a clear spot that they called on the radio for him to head for, and he was able, dead stick, to get over to this spot. But he crashed, and it was about a 20-degree upgrade when he hit the ground. And he hit with such force that it actually broke the airplane. Right at the cockpit, the fuselage was bent about 30 degrees. Although his canopy was open at the time he hit the ground, it had slammed shut from the force. And there's no question in the mind of anybody that he perished in that crash.
Drinks, meats, eggs, vegetables, cereals, bread, snacks, and that's a good place. That's where you find all the candy. Side dishes, and then some little power bars just in case. So we have all this type of food. Some of it is dehydrated.
So many aircraft, they had to create an extra building to hold the others.
operation may never come again. But why, some say, why choose this as our home?
Thing. 2 foot levers, left arm, right arm, 4 or 5 buttons. I was aboard the Ronald Reagan when it was in the shipyard being built.